it's all up here, but it shouldn't be a problem. It's just something but there's a good Wi-Fi reception.
Yeah, I heard they had a little, like, news family or something for it.
Something. I'll never have any issues.
Yeah,
I suppose. Nice things where I'm staff on it. I got to watch the concert from middle school.
How was that?
It was good. It's fun. We had the middle schoolers, not middle schoolers, BC, I guess. BC, I could find them.
Yeah, I heard they were pretty good. I had gym class that time, so I could come here about it.
Do you have. What gym class are you taking this
year? Two sports competitive.
You have more? Yeah, I think they just decided that last year. The counselor Reed came to the amount of training. I guess I think this year's freshman is out of the team.
Yeah, because that's all reserved.
I mean, the point is to get you guys back. You guys need how many FIED credits? I think you just need the two semesters. And then after,
I think that would technically count for two because you have health on the other semester.
Is health a semester class?
Do you teach health class? How's that?
It's fun. I got all my masks this year. It's a little unfortunate.
What unit are you on right now?
For competitive sports?
Yeah.
So Garrett and I got flipped, so when you guys put this out, you're going to alternate. That would be inside. It's going well. It's too bad we couldn't get outdoors.
Yeah.
Last week it was.
Well, I remember last year we did. That was
when I was on fraternity.
Yeah.
Did you guys have freebie most of the days? Was it your class that had freebie? I don't know if she was in.
I don't really remember.
One of the classes didn't really get to play soccer.
Yeah, we didn't play a lot of soccer. I remember that. It was a lot of free time.
I'm going to get out of here before the start so I don't have to walk in front of the lights. But let me know if there's any issues.
Yeah.
Thanks again. I appreciate it. Have a good weekend.
Yes, you too.
And a little neon.
Not enough seats for us, buddy.
Gracias.
Christopher.
I guess I got to hang out with you tonight.
I hate that.
We can't even afford sneakers. Buddy, no. People beat us cold, but Pompeii is Bastille.
You're right.
I think that's because one of Coldplay's most popular songs has Bastille as a feature.
Yeah.
Oh, I gotta go. Hello.
I would like to thank David Detman for being the voice of our concert. He's been doing that for several years. He's one of our English teachers. We're very grateful to have him here. Chris Quisley for recording the show tonight. Garrett Muller, especially Garrett Muller, for letting us use his classroom during his class. We did that for 6 days, so we displaced him 6 times, and it was not nice weather. So I'm especially grateful to Garrett and his class for letting us do that. Daniel Reichel for constantly getting emails from me at really random, weird times of the night, like, oh, I need to book the gym for this and that, and this and that. And she's been very accommodating and worked very hard. We want to thank SEPTA this year. They, through donation, were able to bus over the 4th and 5th grade so that we could do a concert for them on Wednesday morning. And I tell you what, that energy in that group, so fun. So thank you to SEPTA for making that possible, for making that happen. So those are the adults. Some of the adults were thanking, so let's give those folks a round of applause. The kids that you see in front of you, they would kind of wave or step forward. The kids who ran high voltage this year, we have Allison Johnson and Grace Nelson. Give a wave. We've got our exec board members. We have Mackenzie Johnson, Media Communication, Cami Coates, Secretary, Elise Rainmaker, Treasurer, Allison Johnson, Vice President, and Garrett Norton, who I try to say, hey Garrett. And then I say, Mr. President, and he goes, yes. You can wave, everybody. One more time. I give them some really crappy jobs, so it's really nice that I have them. So thank you very much to those kids. I had Madden make a horse today. I mean, who gets to do that? Gavin Stoltenberg for taking care of all of our music edits. If you can give a wave, Gavin. Mackenzie Johnson for creating the program you're holding in your hands. Zach Kovar, Ace Redison, Lindsay Renz, and Kaylee Warren. If you look behind us, that sign, that believer, beautiful believer sign, that they created for us this year. And we do that every year, but it's really nice to have some artistic expression in a different format from our kids. So thank you, and did you wave? Our tech crew tonight is Leland Trudeau. And the fabulous, wonderful Nico Hoot. Thank you, Nico. And Chris Waters, you're here recording tonight, aren't you? And this year's banner carriers, we had Clara Henderson and Mackenzie Loftus. We couldn't do it without you, so thank you so much. One more round of applause for our kids. Hey guys, I'm halfway. Our instructors this year, we had Scott Kovar, who took over percussion, so that's the first time we've had a drumline switch for 10 years, basically. So Scott Kovar, thank you so much for doing that. Jenna Lorenz, who's been by my side almost since she graduated from our program in high school. So Jenna, I don't know, Scott, are you Scott? Okay, that was awkward, sorry. Jenna, I know you're here. Where's Jenna? Wait a minute. 2000 volleyball state champions. That's Jenna. She's working with Color Guard. We have Nate Sicking, who's been with us for several years, a graduate of the program. Miranda Messick helped out as well. Megan Kosmala and Ethan Peter, all graduates of the program. So they kind of know what to expect, and they kind of know how to run things. They've been doing this for a long time. So very grateful for all of those wonderful human beings. So let's give them a round of applause. Just give a wave, you can stand too, so it's easier for people to find you. We have Heather Peter, Cheryl Challener, Lori Scavel, and Haley Ulrich. Let's give them a round of applause. There's so much planning and so much preparation, and I am so grateful for all the parents who are able to make it to the meetings. Not only do we get to do wonderful things for the kids, but I think we have a really wonderful time and we laugh a lot. And a lot of times my husband's like, well, see you in 3 hours, because we just talk forever. And it's just a really fun group. If you're ever interested, you should meet us. I know Heather sends out the agenda, but meet with us, have a great time, just come laugh, and we'll do great things for our kids. So thank you again, parents, for all the donations and all the extra help you've given, whether you were riding the bus or helping us at the state fair or sending, I don't know, applesauce in packets, like whatever it was. The kids have always appreciated that. And one big motivator for kids, if you don't know, similar to me, is food. So thank you for all of that. And thanks for the extra time you've given. A great big thank you to the students and parents who helped set up lights the other night. Teresa Drudeau, Karen Steffens, and I missed this, sorry, Brooke Rassman. She's out there, I think. Melissa Timmerman, and Megan Ackman and Heather Omar. So thank you very much for coming and helping me set up lights before the children's performance on Tuesday night. And thank you to everyone out here for believing in these kids, for believing in our program, for believing that it's valuable and important, not only to our community outside of this building, but the community here inside of this building. I think there's a lot of value that these kids bring to our community, both in and out of our school, and I'm very, very proud of them. Seniors are gonna have something special for their parents planned tonight. We've got basically the senior night a little bit as well at the end. So once you feel it safe, once the seniors have taken their final bows, I'll turn around and I'll wave you down. So carefully kind of plan out your path to come down. You just want to make sure you don't trip on anything or anybody on your way down. We want to make sure that you also have a few moments to appreciate this and the close of this part of their year. It's a lot of hard work that the kids put in throughout the entire season, and it starts almost back in June and July for some of these kids. And this is the culmination of their work. And we are excited to show this or share this with you tonight. So after the show, seniors will line up for their annual photo over here by the Tiger Eyes, and I know High Voltage does as well. And I want to make sure that we take that time. For any of the students who are here, student section tonight, I would love to have you join us after we do some of those as well. I'd love to get some snapshots of you with the crew. I think it's really special that you're here, so thank you for being here. So here it is. Okay, so on Monday night, I was at US Bank with my husband and my son. We were at the Vikings 49ers game, and the decibel level was like 112 and 116. This lady was plugging her ears, felt really old, but I was really going deaf at the time. But I will tell you, when the fourth and fifth graders came here, when the lights went out, this place about burst my eardrums. They were rolling their feet on the bleachers, they were screaming their heads off, and you know when little kids scream, it's like, I think she's great, right? But my gosh, I think they would have knocked US Bank sound out of the park. So you have a little work to do tonight, folks, okay? So if you see something you like, if you hear something you like, you need to let people know, okay? So we're gonna give a little 1 to 10 woot, like, there's one. Ready? Yeah. I don't want to hear any of that. not gonna happen. Okay. So like a fiver, like yeah. That's not five. No. Ready? Go. Okay. That's what I got. Now I want you to like 9.5 it. Save the 10 for later, right? I don't want you to hurt yourself. So you gotta really look. It was a good attempt. It started over here, right? But we need a boom! It's gotta be from the gut, from the soul! Woo! Ready? Yeah, that's gonna last a lot longer, right? That was pretty short. I gave you a break on that one. Alright. Alright, kids. Kids. We'll call you kids. It's fun. I like being a mom too. It's all good. Alright, we're gonna get rocking. We're gonna get rolling. You guys ready for a show? Let's try that again. Are you guys ready for a show?
To work together and learn. Created by Kelly Lassick and led by senior Allison Johnson and junior Grace Nelson, High Voltage is entering its 22nd year of existence. 16 members strong, the group has been hard at work since late September, learning and perfecting their drill. With the help of special lighting effects and heart-pumping music, we hope to captivate you with a truly shocking experience, High Voltage.
Okay.
The Stuartville Marching Tigers are proud to be performing for you tonight. Students began learning their music in July and had band camp in August. On August 27th, the band officially marched for the first time at the state fair, earning both a participation trophy and taking fourth place in their class. After a short break, it was on to the Waseca Marching Classic on Saturday, September 23rd, where they earned first place in their class. On Saturday, September 30th, the band traveled to the Laverne Tri-State Band Festival and placed second in their class. Finally, that same day, in 93-degree heat, the band traveled to Algona, Iowa, to compete in the Algona Band Days. They placed first in their class. First. First overall, and brought home the Sweepstakes Trophy. The marching band is made up of 66 members, consisting of grades 9 through 12. Our instructors are Ethan Peter and Megan Kosmala, who help with the brass line, Nate Sinking and Miranda Messick with the woodwinds, Scott Kovar with drumline, and Jenna Lorenz with color guard. This year, the band is focused on belief, to have hope. We have all had to overcome so much, and many of us have found that the recovery from the last few years has not been as easy or positive as we had imagined it might be. Yet we still hold on to our hope, the belief that things will improve, they will get better, and that we will continue to get stronger, healthier, and happier. There are no other options. We must choose to be believers. So tonight, the Marching Tigers will be performing their parade show for you. It is entitled Believer by Imagine Dragons, arranged by Tom Wallace and percussion by Tony McCutcheon. And now, let's welcome the Stuartville Marching Tigers.
Thank you.
Although Coldplay's Viva La Vida may be considered a modern classic, the underlying themes of the French Revolution may be lost in its melodic strings. Viva La Vida is Coldplay's highest charting single, yet many fans fail to recognize the central idea of the song is a retelling of the French Revolution and the death of King Louis XVI. Please enjoy Viva La Vida by Coldplay, arranged by Tom Wallace. It was topping charts for months from October 2013 before peaking in March of 2014. Please enjoy Pompeii, arranged by Tom Wallace and percussion by Tony McCutcheon. Hopefully, you will be erupting from your seats.
Thank you.
members, senior Emily Steffens, junior Marcus Johnson, and sophomores Violet Osterman, Abby Hesch, Madison Manning, Ava May, along with co-captains Brooklyn Rassman and Madeline Cratchy. Each year, the Color Guard writes their own unique feature, which is a choreographed routine that incorporates elements of both dance and flag work. Performing to Enter Sandman, ladies and gentlemen, we present to you the Stuartville Color Guard. Even though it came out in 1987, there are still millions of plays worldwide. The music video features a redhead dancing his heart out and has about around 1.4 billion plays on YouTube. Feel free to sing and dance along.
Thank you.
There is no doubt that Taylor Swift is on top of the music industry. From the Eras Tour to her re-release of her album 1989, which came out today, by the way, she has captured the world with her catchy tunes. In fact, there is one in particular that I would guess that everyone in this gym knows, and that's Shake It Off. Even though the players play and haters hate, we encourage you to shake, shake, shake it off with us. If you know the words, we'd love to have you sing along with us. We hope you enjoy this number, this number one hit, arranged by Michael Orr. From Believer, Cassidy Byers, and after, each section will be performing their own written features. Now, let's welcome the 2023 Stuartville Drumline. Time to show off the hardware, which is a testament to all the hard work these kids have put in this year. On August 27th, the Tigers began their competitive marching season by marching at the State Fair Parade, where they received a participation plaque and earned fourth place. The plaque is presented by band media specialist Mackenzie Johnson. The Marching Tigers then competed at the Waseca Marching Classic on Saturday, September 23rd. After a hard day's work, the Stewartville Band placed first in their division. The first place trophy is presented by band treasurer and drum major Elise Raymaker. On Saturday, September 30th, the band traveled to the Laverne Tri-State Band Festival. Here to present their second place trophy is band secretary and clarinet section leader, Cammy Hoth. And later that same day, the band traveled to Iowa for the Algona Band Days competition and took first in their class. Here to present the trophy is band vice president and saxophone section leader, Allison Johnson. In addition to placing first, the band also earned the sweepstakes trophy, placing first overall out of eight bands. Here to present the sweepstakes trophy is band president and drumline captain Garrett Norton. Congratulations, Tiger Marching Band, for a fantastic season.
To be my sunshine after the rain. I'm gonna turn on a light for you. Okay. So give me one moment. Yeah.